Are you or a loved one receiving Social Security Disability, otherwise known as SSD, or Social Security Supplemental Income, otherwise known as SSI? If so, please don't fool yourself into believing that these benefits will continue forever. I'm Attorney Scott Rubin of Rubin and Badame Law, and we practice Social Security Disability Law. With over 25 years of combined experience representing people applying for SSD and SSI, we have seen horror stories of people's benefits being terminated wrongfully. Social Security is required by law to review every recipient of SSD or SSI benefits every 3 to 7 years and decide if medical improvement has occurred. First, the recipient receives a letter from Social Security that they're under a continuing disability review and they need to complete certain forms. These forms must be completed and they ask about treatment at doctors or blood tests. Eventually, Social Security decides if medical improvement has occurred to the extent the person can now work. If Social Security decides the person still is unable to work, the review is over. But if Social Security decides that medical improvement has occurred to the extent the person is able to work at a certain level, the individual receives an initial cessation notice. The recipient has 10 days to appeal the cessation notice by filing a request for reconsideration. If the appeal is filed within 10 days of the date of the cessation notice received, the benefits and health insurance will continue. If the recipient files an appeal within 65 days initial cessation letter being received, but after the 10 days, the benefits will not continue, but the appeal will go on. The second stage is the reconsideration stage, where again, Social Security sends out forms to the recipient, and the recipient must complete the forms about treatment. Social Security at the reconsideration stage may also send the recipient to a doctor for an evaluation. Again, it's important that the recipient cooperates. Social Security then decides at the reconsideration stage whether the individual is still unable to work, meaning medical improvement has not occurred, or if medical improvement has occurred, whether the individual can indeed work. If so, Social Security sends out a reconsideration cessation letter to the recipient stating that your benefits will cease and that you are able to work. Again, the recipient has appeal rights. The recipient can file a request for a hearing before an administrative law judge, and if done within 10 days from receiving the cessation reconsideration denial notice, benefits and insurance will continue until a final decision after a hearing, or if the recipient files a request for a hearing within 65 days of receiving the cessation notice, the benefits will not continue, but the appeal will go on. If an appeal, a request for a hearing is filed timely, eventually there will be a hearing before an administrative law judge, who will decide after looking at all the evidence and speaking to the recipient whether the recipient can return to work. If the administrative law judge finds that medical improvement has not occurred to the extent the individual can work, the benefits and the insurance continue. However, if the administrative law judge decides that medical improvement has occurred and the recipient is able to work at a certain level, benefits and insurance will be ceased. Also, at that time, Social Security could request that all the money paid to the recipient during the appeals be repaid. However, again, the recipient can appeal that decision if he made all the appeals in good faith. I'm attorney Scott Rubin of Rubin and Badame Law, and we represent people applying for SSD and SSI. It's important that you know your rights when it comes to SSD and SSI. And that's why we created an important guide. It's a free, quick, and easy to read checklist of the five most common mistakes people make when applying for SSD and SSI. All you have to do is click on your email and we'll send a copy directly to your inbox. Protect your rights when it comes to receiving benefits that you've earned. Our law firm, Rubin and Badame, is in fact a law firm. Many places advertise on social media for SSD and SSI applications. They're not law firms. They're businesses from some faraway state that process claims for profits where you never even meet an attorney. Contact Rubin and Badame Law if you have any questions regarding an application for SSD or SSI, or any questions regarding your current benefits or being reviewed. Thank you.